It's personal.
I didn't know that either.
That's on the...
27.
Classification.
When is it, March 27th?
27, 5 o'clock here.
Yeah, March 27th, which is Monday, at 5.
What's that meeting on now?
I guess there's a hearing on the, salary schedule?
Hearing on the salary schedule.
March 27.
Well, there's a, we have a hearing, informational meeting.
They get told the public, is advertised.
Yeah, and it went in, I guess, everybody's paychecks, too.
Yeah.
Make sure that everybody...
And when is that, Bruce?
Monday night, just coming to 27, 5 o'clock.
Monday.
So you'll take written comments, because I won't be gonna come, I have two other meetings.
Thank you for those changes, Bruce.
Oh, there should have been, because they're in my minutes, I should have written them down.
Okay, we've got minutes from...
Last week.
March, well, March 16 and March 20.
And March what?
March 16.
March 20 is this Thursday, 21st.
We didn't meet the 20th.
From March...
16.
20th, we didn't meet.
We're going to meet Monday.
We're going to meet.
But we couldn't meet.
Right.
And that was the email.
Okay, that's just, that's the...
It was, just to back up the information, because we voted.
And then we didn't.
And we couldn't do it, so that was the reason.
Okay.
Emails attached.
So this is...
March 16, you get to the same page?
No, they're different.
Well, just two pages, there's three pages.
Okay, so it's three pages. So there's, all right. So we've got then the minutes from March 16.
Yep.
I'll make a motion that we move the minutes of March 16 from the Finance Committee meeting.
So a motion, do we have a second?
Yep.
Second.
Any further discussion?
I'd just like to add the date of the personnel public hearing at 5 o'clock and the public hearing at Frontier School. They might know...
It's at Frontier?
No, the Frontier budget. Did they have that meeting already? We discussed...
They changed it.
Actually, I'm thinking they were meeting tonight.
I had it written down as the 29th.
Leave it there, that's...
It's okay.
If you wanted to, you could go out and take a look at it.
That's fine.
It's not worth it.
Not worth the effort.
It's tomorrow night, Frontier meeting tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, so it is the 22nd. So change it to the 22nd.
Yep.
Yeah, that's right, I think that's at 6 o'clock also. And then the personnel board at 5 o'clock. So do you want to make those changes?
Yes, please.
Okay. So we have, it's been moved and seconded, we have two changes. Personnel board, public hearing on the proposed contract, March 27 at 5 o'clock.
Yes.
Public hearing on the Frontier Regional School is March 22nd, and I believe that's 6 o'clock.
Okay.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Okay. I would like to see if we can get finished with these omnibus budget articles. I realize that as we go through them, there are questions that come up and that we can't answer, quite honestly, in some cases. If we can answer them, or if they're not material, then I don't think it's a problem. But, you know, there are sometimes the salaries, for example. So at the moment, you know, we could put them off and do them down the road, but we're now 5 weeks, actually a little less than 5 weeks from town meeting. And we really need to get to the bottom line here someplace so that we can compare what we're recommending for expenditures with what we have for revenues.
Skim's budget, we don't have that yet.
The budget's in there, and we can have that. If we get through these, then we certainly can take a look at that tomorrow.
There was two other budgets we haven't voted on yet. One was the Board of Health expenses.
Yeah, those are in here, aren't they?
No. Oh, they're old.
Yeah,
they're old. They've been on hold forever. And then the one budget, the training budget, which was $4,000.
Emergency?
Yeah.
That's up in the air. That's in the selectmen's daily wick.
Okay, so that's not something we have to worry about.
At the moment.
Okay. Well, we are going to vote on Skim at some point, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So that might be tomorrow night?
If you want it, I will make sure that we have it here tomorrow night, whether we get to vote on it, but we can certainly discuss it. If we get through these things, that's pretty much that one. What else we've got? We've got the wastewater treatment plant.
Yeah, they're all in here, yeah. There's a whole bunch we go through tonight.
Well, I'm not even sure we're not going to get the wastewater treatment plant now. I don't think we have that, do we?
Yes, we do.
We do? Okay. All right, so if we can, I think the next one, we did do the school, the elementary school. The regional school, there should be a new...
There's a new one.
Frontier Regional, we got a thing in our box.
Yeah.
The new number's $3,588. That's the one you should have.
Yeah, went down about $100,000.
Yeah, and that $100,000 wasn't that their budget went down, they're using $100,000 from their free cash EMD account.
For every town?
No, in total. That's what reduced their budget.
They have a separate account up there, they call it EMD.
Yeah.
It's like our free cash.
Right, they use that...
And they can save up to 5% in their budget, but that they don't have to use any of it if they don't want to. But anything over 5% by law, they have to give back to the towns.
The prior budget did reduce it, $157,000.
So in this case, they're reducing it.
Reducing it again, another $100,000?
Apparently.
Because they were leaving with $57,000 in that EMD account.
It's okay by me.
Okay.
Well, but it doesn't take into account whatever they're going to put into it this year. It's like our free cash.
No, I know.
We moved the free cash down to $300,000 or whatever it was last year.
Because they have a stabilization budget also, right?
No.
No.
They do not.
No, they don't. The only thing they've got in that respect is that so-called EMD.
Okay.
Which is essentially free cash. Okay, so you've got the elementary school budget and you've got Frontier's budget. The old Frontier budget was increased to $176,945. I've got the old one here. And this one is up $100,760. So it's a $76,200 reduction. Mm-hmm. And so they must have used more than $100,000. They must have used closer to $150,000. So what's your pleasure on
that? Can I ask a question?
You can. I don't know if I got an answer.
On their submittal, page 35 of 36 on the budget that they had set, mm-hmm. on their FY funding sources. I don't see any school choice funds for their funding source. What happened to that $1 million?
That's still there. As of the last meeting, we didn't use it anymore. That was what I thought.
Well, that's why I'm asking, because I don't see anything on this sheet.
I think there's over 300,000. is what I recall from listening to the...
On school choice?
Yes.
It seemed to, yeah, I can see what you've got there.
What page?
Is there any other place where you see school choice?
This is 35 and 36, yeah, that one, page 35. They're FY18, looks to me like they're, the budget proposal is receiving tuition of 1.16 million, and okay, wait a minute here. The school choice sending is 232,000.
Oh, yeah, and you know, they, essentially what they end up doing, if I remember what Patty said, and you may be able to tell by looking at it, is they cover their school choice sending with their school choice receiving, and they're close to being the same.
Okay.
The question is, are they? And I don't know.
Okay, well, I'm, you know, there again, I'm going by this, and it looks like, well, unfortunately, they've got a whole bunch of numbers added together, so it's...
It says that would be used to reduce salaries.
As well as the charter school.
Yeah, right, and the charter school is, charter school sending is way up, that's 767, almost 768,000.
In their narrative, they said that 199,151 for fiscal 18, those funds will be used to reduce salaries from the Frontier Regional School budget.
No, I missed that.
First page, second page.
That's 3 of 37.
What they're doing is they're shifting some salaries of the school.
Yeah.
And covering with school choice monies.
Deerfield Elementary.
And that will work for a short period of time, but when it hits the fan, they're not going to have that school choice money, and then...
The budget's going to go...
And then you're going to be in a serious situation. Your budget's either going to skyrocket, or you're going to have to cut services, or increase taxes. Because it's not, obviously, as I said before, it's not sustainable. And even now, I appreciate their efforts. They're, you know, trying to reduce the budget, but they're still at 2.89.
Right. And that's, you know, that's a better job than they've done other years. So, mm-hmm. I mean, that's, you know, I mean, they've done a real good job compared to other years.
Skip, you want a motion on this?
Yeah.
I move that we authorize $3,588,786 for Frontier Regional School.
And I will be more than happy to ask for an explanation. Bring that tomorrow.
The funding?
Yeah. What happened to school choice? I'll see if I can find whatever I can find it here, and then I'll ask. I'll call back. We have a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Moved, seconded. Any further discussion? Any other items that... If there are none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed? One opposed? Abstentions? So 6-1-0.
The 21st.
That's what happens when you retire.
Frontier, there is no Frontier Capital. Frontier Transportation.
Would that be included in what they're requesting?
No. Frontier Capital was, we just paid for the school, finished paying for the school. That's what that was the...
20-year bond.
Yeah,
but what if they needed $20,000 worth of audio video.
Put it into their budget.
And put it, that's my question, be in their budget.
Actually, there's a warrant article.
I was going to say, isn't there something to do with...
There's going to be a warrant article on, for a capital item, which is school improvements, roof insulation, painting potentially.
Are we going to need to know that in order to...
I asked that last meeting.
To determine where we're going to go.
You said Frontier, we don't have any, you don't have any voice. We don't have any voice on the capital.
No, but I think we need to know the number.
Well...
To decide what we're going to do.
We'll know when it's on the warrant article, I guess.
No, we need to know.
Do they have a separate stabilization account?
That's what I asked, and you said no.
They do not.
No.
No.
So are we on Frontier Transportation now?
I just want to write the down, so there is, you have an expectation of an article someplace, but you haven't seen the Capital Improvement Committee.
They don't come to us, because it's not...
No.
It's not our vote.
They spent $6,000 to do a study. The study came up with several alternatives. They supposedly will make their final decision and submit a warrant article or something.
The, I think the warrant closes tomorrow night.
I don't know.
Sound right?
Actually, I think it's open tomorrow night and closes the 30th.
Then, okay.
I believe.
You don't know until they open their mouth and make a motion on the second day.
Just another quick question on this funding. The assessment to the town, does that include circuit breaker and all the rest of that stuff?
No. Circuit breaker, should be...
That should be a source of funding, right?
Yeah, and it should be a source of funding someplace.
Well, it's not on their list. That's what I'm saying. I'm just wondering if they included in the assessments to towns.
So circuit breaker means they had other funding.
I think they kicked them up as far as the town warrants. I think they kicked them up.
Okay. Any else?
I know some meeting tomorrow night for...
So Frontier Transportation, $56,793.
Does anybody know why it's going up?
They do have an increase in sped students.
That's for...
Which require the smaller buses.
Yeah.
Could be that, I don't know.
That was my understanding. That's what I had heard. That there were some additional special ed students.
Well, that's if they're...
As far as transportation.
That's their estimate. Where is it? I think it goes from 120 to 140.
Well, if you look on the, their cost supposedly for transportation is slightly less than 300,000. They've deducted state reimbursement, 168,000. Less whatever the FY 2016 assessment
is.
What was about excess?
So
less excess.
Well, no, I'm sorry. That's just what's sitting there for 2017.
Yeah, right.
And we don't have any of that information.
No. So it's just a number. That's all we get.
So what's your pleasure?
Don't like it, but make a motion, we approve it. $56,793.
Second? I'll second it. Gets it on the table. Discussion?
I think we need to know why before we vote it.
I think they discussed it. It's an additional special...
I don't know. They were here, and I don't remember what the actual discussion was. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 All opposed?
Opposed.
Two. Step, abstentions? So is it 5-2?
5-2-0.
I guess now that it should it be an abstention if I don't want to vote for, because I don't think we have enough information.
No, abstain.
Should I abstain or vote against?
It's up to you.
No, I mean, what would...
I'm voting against it because there's not enough information.
That's fine, I don't have a problem.
That's the same with me, all right. I just wonder if we should abstain.
The problem is, if we always say that about every budget, we wouldn't pass one budget. I think what we got to do is get through the whole list, and then see where we stand, see whether we can support it. If we can't support it, then at that point, we look for places to cut. The problem is, if we turn around, I can find something wrong with every one of these budgets, but I'm not gonna, because there's, like I said, I don't like it, but I made the motion to pass it, because we've got to keep things moving along.
Why don't we just take the number and see if we can support it, not discuss it?
That's my feeling. You take the bottom line, then you go back and look.
Why bother
the effort here? Why even discuss it?
We did have the school's superintendent and the business manager were here.
We didn't have...
I think they did mention something about extra.
No, but in reference to what John's saying, which I understand.
Well, I mean, the thing is that, if you look, I don't know how the school committee's doing it now, but my recollection of when I was on the school committee, that we would spend 3 or 4 or 5 meetings just on the budget. And when we got through, I don't know that, you know, despite the fact that we've essentially gone over all of it, that all of us didn't have some other question someplace along the way. We've spent, an hour here with the superintendent and business manager, and there's just no way in that hour that you could possibly...
No.
Because there's always something new that pops up that you don't understand.
Well, they have a subcommittee that reviews, that creates the budget.
They have a subcommittee at Frontier.
At Frontier, then they bring it to the...
At the elementary school, they don't use subcommittees.
And it's presented to them as... They don't understand it any more than you and I do.
Well, that's the problem with the subcommittee thing, because they're not going to vote it until...
I know.
Tomorrow. And I don't know how much time they've had to... All right. Franklin Tech, assessment.
I had a question.
Sure, I don't know that I've got an answer.
Why is the assessment per pupil different? If you look at page 8.
Of what, their budget?
Their annual assessments.
Yes, $18,000.
$18,029.
Okay.
Why are we being Deerfield, higher than, per pupil than the other towns?
That's the Department of Ed, state law. We're the wealthy town in the district. Other poorer towns contribute less.
Really? Okay.
Yes.
That's why. Okay.
And where they come up with that number, I have no idea.
So it's Boston. Okay.
But at least in part, it's Boston.
Okay.
You can go to the hearings and find out, and they still won't know.
Still won't.
I spent a whole day there.
We can ask Kitty James to come in and explain to us, but she won't know. Kitty James is the...
So there's...
No, you answered it. Okay, I didn't know why. I looked at this and said, why are they doing it? Okay.
There are only 5 people in the state that understood the formula, and 4 just died, so there's no...
And the other guy's not talking. Okay.
I got one more question.
Sure.
If you take on page 8-9, the fiscal year 18 assessment for Deerfield is $288,464.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We're supposed to be 3.66% of the total, 5,824.
That's the increase, I think.
That comes to 213,250.
Huh.
I'm just wondering where they get their numbers then.
I have no idea. I just know that this is a 21% increase over last year. That's all I can tell you.
And we're down, 2 students?
No, we're up 2.
Up 2?
We're up 2.
Oh,
that's
down 2.
We're up 2. Mm. When we, at town meeting, we usually have the superintendent and the business manager. And
So I guess we would have the possibility to ask the question there, or?
No, that would be, now that I look at it, that would be because of Boston also.
Okay.
The state formula.
You can see that the formula's in there and it worked.
Well, that's why we'd be high. That's why we're high.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Do you have a motion?
Move that we authorize $288,464 for Franklin County Tech Assessment.
I'll second.
We have a motion, a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstentions? 7-0-0?
Yes.
Highway Department, salaries.
I have a question.
Sure. So just let me point out, for whatever reason, the salaries are up only 1.2%.
Yeah, that's my concern. That these salaries.
These are the new ones.
These are the new salaries, and they must have been so close to the new step that they only got minimal increases.
No. Not all of them.
Because that we made sure that didn't happen.
Well, we already have one that didn't get any, lost money.
Well, that's because they're over the top.
No.
We got a new hire brings it down quite a bit. The heavy equipment.
I'm talking the director's superintendent salary.
Well, I was looking at that. That doesn't look right to me.
It's really the only one that I question. And then I also question the foreman's 50 hours of overtime at the transfer station. Those are two things that I had.
But that's not. The transfer station, we're not looking at the transfer station.
Well, it's in here.
It's
an allocation of the overall cost.
They do work up there. They work up there.
Transferring 50 hours at time and a half to the wastewater treatment plant.
That's wastewater.
Okay, wastewater treatment. Okay, got it.
Yeah, that's.
Makes sense. So, but the superintendent's salary only went up less than $100.
I noticed, well, yeah.
But he should be at a different.
Don't forget, 5/6 of that's paid for by the town, and 1/6 is paid for by.
The sewer, yeah, but the sewer.
But it should have been paid for.
They should be incremental.
Total amount in here.
The sewer went up, $7.
Yeah, something's not right.
Doesn't the 6 of this salary come from the wastewater treatment?
That's still.
Yeah, but it's only $7.
And Bruce just said it went up $7, wastewater treatment.
So is Kevin maxed out?
No.
He was maxed out.
He's in a different level now.
He's the.
He was one.
And I thought he was step 9, to be honest.
It says he's step 6, 8.
Yeah, I thought he was step 9.
I think that's a wrong step.
So, I mean, I will ask that question.
So.
Oh, you have to add the next line to that, don't you?
You do. But both of those are only up. They're less than $100 from last year. And if we're going to give a $3,500 raise to a foreman, and give less than $100 raise to the superintendent, doesn't make any sense at all to me.
Just a guess, because he was overpaid based on the change in schedules.
No, it's because you automatically, get a raise every year, that's the problem.
It's going to continue.
Well, we should probably check that one. You got that question?
So we had somebody, was that a step 10, now moves down to a step 6, and gets a $3,600 raise.
So where do you see, well, there's a couple of them that get less than that.
Well, the foreman at 48, foreman, maintenance equipment operator.
The, okay, the reason for that, look at the grade.
Yeah.
The grade...
Went from 2 to a 3.
Yes.
Because they got more, they have more ability now, they have more licenses?
He was appointed a foreman this year.
Okay.
So at the start of the year, he was grade 2.
He was, okay.
Okay.
So we have two foremen?
Yes, yeah.
One for maintenance and one for...
Yeah, buildings and grounds, and the other one for highways or something like that. Exactly sure what it is, but there are two foremen. And that, he was just a regular, he was a heavy equipment operator the beginning of last, beginning of this year.
All right.
But the other one, the other foreman is less than $100.
Well, they're maxed out. They're at step 10.
The other foreman stayed the same, essentially.
Yeah, well, yeah, less than $100.
Right.
No call this year.
$8.
At the highest step.
Don't forget, you got to look down the bottom to see how many years they got.
Yeah, plus the longevity, yeah.
Because of the longevity.
Yeah.
Another $500.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so there is longevity going in this year. And when does that start? Year 10?
July 1st.
Year 10?
They don't get it paid until next year.
Year 11 or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, but Kevin doesn't get any longevity either, so...
Well, he hasn't been here that long.
No.
He's still a young kid.
Yeah.
So are we.
I know we are. And he's still getting more than we are. Make a motion that we approve $439,052 for highway department salaries.
Second.
Moved in second. And I will check that one out tomorrow, see if there's, because I think there seems to be some problems in there. Okay. We have a motion, do we have a second?
Yes.
Moved in second. Any other discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I'm against it. I think some people are getting too big a raise.
So, abstentions? So 6-1-0?
Yeah.
Give me just a second so that I can talk with Brenda tomorrow, I'll know exactly what it is that I'm going to vote it. Okay, highway department expenses.
Did he put sewer in here? Because that was a question we had before.
Yes.
Looks like it. Heating, water, sewer's up $1,000 from a year ago.
It's an estimate.
Heating, water, and sewer.
Like the fifth row down, fifth line down.
Yep.
So say that again?
Heat, water, and sewer. The question was...
Okay, okay.
Did they put sewer in?
Well, it doesn't.
It's up by $1,000.
I wonder if he's too high with sweeping basins and line painting. He's only through February, he's only, or through January, he's only spent 30% of last year's appropriation.
On which?
So maybe there's a chance to make up some money here. Sweeping basins and line painting.
They do a lot of that in the spring, though.
Do a lot of that in the spring, from what I understand.
Okay, makes sense, all right, yeah.
Tree work, Kevin, when I talked with him, said that most of their tree work will be done in the spring.
Mm-hmm.
Guess they're going to put a lot of time in it.
Right.
That makes sense.
There's a road over that he wanted to open up over there by still water.
Yeah.
Make a motion, we approve $242,400.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
Opposed?
Abstain.
Okay, so 6-0-1. Transfer station expense is down $2,500. And you have salaries in there? Yeah.
They have salaries, but they're not just broken out.
The salaries aren't broken out, and there's enough money to cover the salary increases.
With the new...
It looks like you might be a couple high on some of them.
I thought we just did that one.
Skip, if you want to get into it.
What's that?
The general highway.
Based on the run rate through January, it looks like bulky, transfer station bulky items and recycling, he's got two high. Bulky items, if he continues on the same track, it'll be $10,000.
So how much have we spent so far?
Well, it will be $10,000 if it continues at the same rate. I gotta look and see what it's so far.
Well, people are cleaning out some stuff in the spring.
This is a budget that's come from, was it 250-something thousand?
Yes.
5 years ago, 4 years ago?
He's trying to save some money here.
Down to $187,000.
He's only spent $6,500 through February on bulky items. Recycling, he spent $10,000 through February. So maybe it's a chance to make some money here.
So bulky items and which else? What else?
Recycling.
Recycling. I'm not going to get you the information on that tomorrow. Kevin's on vacation.
Since the overall budget went down, I'm going to make a motion that we approve the $187,500.
I'll second that.
It's been moved, seconded. So is that, it's okay? If I don't get that information tomorrow, it's just, you know, all I can do is ask Brenda what we've actually had. And, you know, I can provide that information. But why we need those numbers that high at this point in time?
That's just conservative, so.
Well,
as long as it's conservative, I'm okay.
Depends on what you mean by conservative.
Where the tax rate will be higher than,
yeah,
could be higher than if it goes down.
Well, no. I mean, if it goes down, we might save a few bucks here and there.
Yeah.
Yes.
But voting on this now is conservative.
So, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions? 700.
That's your lucky number today.
I hope so. Next, test well monitoring.
Make a motion to approve 70,000.
Yeah, I talked to Kevin. He said he could probably do 70,000.
Second. Do we have a contract? I mean, I don't understand why somebody would say I could probably do.
No, there's no contract that I know of. It's not like we have a contract that says they're coming in every, you know, 30 days.
There's no monitoring. There's no inspection.
Yeah, there is monitoring. That's why he's got money in there for testing. And they come in periodically. They take the water out and they sample it. And they send it, the results, to us and to the state DEP.
Oh, I understand all that. They do it once a year, twice a year. I mean, they have to have a contract.
More than once a year.
They do it more than once a year, but how many times, I can't tell you.
And the question then becomes, what if they find something?
Yeah.
Then they go back and they start doing it more frequently, so the testing expenses go up.
Mm-hmm.
That's okay. Kevin's answer was, look, I just don't know.
That's fine.
You know, but you know, I'm pretty sure I can live with 70,000. Yeah. The tests have been good.
Been good.
His run rate is...
I think that's why he changed.
If he continues this way, it's going to be 60, so.
All right. Yeah.
Which is good. Because the rest goes into free cash.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so do we have a motion?
You still pay taxes.
And it was seconded.
Moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? 700.
Who moved it?
I did.
Bruce.
Jeff.
Or seconded, I'm
second,
sorry.
Bruce seconded.
John moved it.
Okay.
John moved it and Bruce
John
seconded.
Pachura moved it.
Don't make any difference. You can take credit occasionally.
He did in the minutes.
I don't even read that portion.
I know.
Doesn't make any difference who makes a motion.
Board of Health.
We had a lot of questions on this, right?
Yep.
This is, at least, what I can tell you is that someplace along the way, Dick is trying to bow out, he's somewhat. So he's not going to be spending 40 hours a week in here next year.
No, did he spend 40 hours a week in here before, or 20?
He spends whatever he spends now, which is approximately 40 hours a week.
Between both of them.
Between the two of them.
Between the two positions. So he's not going to be, as I understand it, I believe he's going to be doing this one. And someone else, and then he's going to be splitting the other one, or slowly moving out of it next year. The building inspector.
What's that account number, anybody?
512.
That's kind of unknown at this point, because he has a commissioner's license, so there may have to.
What is the proof you got?
512, 5100, 5110?
No. Building inspection. I think we're over budget.
There was $98,000 for the two.
No, he's trying to get somebody else in.
If you added both the numbers together.
He's got more than 2,088 hours we're budgeting.
Well, he's budgeting two people, himself and a train, and a new person for the inspector.
Oh, for the transition time?
Transition, 3 months transition.
Well, even with the transition, once the transition is complete, there will be a separate building inspector and a separate health agent.
But if he's only working 2,088, they won't be working 2,088, then are they going to be working more time than he does in total?
Well, he's only in here for 836.
Yeah, but take the building inspection one, too.
And part of that building inspector is someone that's coming in that's taking over his job.
Yeah, because we're not going to hire.
I'm talking about after transition.
After transition, we don't.
I think the intent is that Dick will not be the building inspector.
His name is only in there, it doesn't mean he's.
I'm talking about total hours, whether it's him or Joe Jones.
Total hours is going to be 60 hours.
Total, yeah, that's right.
40 for one position, 20.
So it's going to be more than he's spending?
Yes.
Right, more than he's doing at this time.
More than he's doing now.
I wonder why that happens.
Well, part of it, I think, is grown because when he took the position, he was filling both. Most towns don't have one person filling both. Most towns, I think, their building inspector, that's a separate position from the Board of Health. So, and I think that's where this whole transition is coming from.
I guess.
I believe.
We're talking about in the future, but not this year, but if it can be done in 40 hours.
But he's only going to work 40 hours a week.
Can I finish now? If it can be done in 40 hours now, why can't it be done in 40 hours when two new people come by?
I don't know if you'll be able to find one person do both positions.
You won't.
You won't.
Okay.
So the question that.
They're not trained that way.
Let me rephrase your question. Do we need a building inspector 40 hours a week, which is what we're likely to have?
Yeah, you can put it that way.
Probably not.
But anyway, that's not this budget, so never mind, moving on.
And all this budget's paid for out of.
But the building inspector, don't we have to have a commissioner?
Right, the fees. So we, I don't know, I agree with you, John. I agree.
We're adding hours at some point.
There's no question, 20 hours.
Make a motion, we approve $33,507 for building inspector, Board of Health salary.
We have a motion, do we have a second?
I'll second.
Motion and a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions? 700. Senior center expenses. The senior center expenses are up because of the salary budget.
Yeah, I have a question about that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Did we skip one?
Yeah, we didn't do the Board of Health expense.
Yeah, we did that last week.
We did.
Not by my record.
I don't have it.
No?
I don't have it.
No.
I said we tabled it.
Where was it?
512, 5400.
We haven't gotten to that point yet.
What number?
512, 5400.
On their sheet, it's red still.
Yeah, it was tabled.
That must be in the book.
It was tabled February 22nd.
Board of Health expenses tabled, okay.
Oh, I know why.
And we didn't.
Yeah, that's right.
5/12.
That's what I brought up, that we had, exactly.
That mosquito get you?
Mosquito.
Mosquito.
Mosquitoes.
Lights on in there?
Where?
No.
As soon as you walk in, they'll turn on though.
Well, and maybe they met here and went off. They were going someplace tonight, I don't know where it was.
Trevor's car was out.
Trevor's car was out there.
Oh, probably went to Wolfie's then.
No, well, no, they were going someplace else.
Oh, no, it's supposed to be Thursday night.
What?
Thursday night, they have a meeting in Charlemont.
They must have something tonight.
Yeah, maybe they went to Wolfie's.
Maybe they're having a beer out there.
Well, they're gonna have a beer out there in Charlemont.
So, what would you like to do with the $11,000? That's what you're talking about, right?
Why don't we?
I think.
We didn't put them in contracted services?
I'll second it for you.
Well, we put it on hold every meeting.
I know that, well, either we're gonna address it or we're not.
Well, my feeling is we should address it and say that.
Make a motion.
I make a motion that we not approve this budget.
Okay.
Well, that's fine, we wouldn't approve it if we voted.
So the question is, how much do you want to approve?
How much do you want to approve?
I haven't got it in front of me, was it $10,000 from mosquitoes?
$11,000.
$11,000.
So if the budget was $11,000 less, is that what you're asking for?
I would say, I would make a motion.
$24,530 would be the.
$24,530 would be the, which is the same as last year.
Yeah, $24,530.
Wait a minute.
Somebody's in there.
There we go, come on out here so we can yell at you.
Used to that.
If we weren't on camera, I would use horror language. What's the $11,000 for mosquitoes for?
The Board of Health.
We couldn't get the mosquito, speaking for Carol now, obviously, but.
Well, you're spokesman tonight.
I guess I am.
Hot seat.
So I think she's requesting that again to work with VDCI because she couldn't get the, she's got a grant from the Community Compact Grant to put together a mosquito district for Pioneer Valley and all the towns. A lot of towns are signing up or wanting to sign up to be put in for up and down the valley to monitor mosquitoes. It's a long process to get put in, and the way that they're doing it, I believe, is putting it as a voluntary contribution. So there would be a small set amount that you would put in, and then if you wanted different à la carte features throughout doing that, you'd have the ability to do that. That's not gonna be set up this year, so she's hoping, she's requesting again, I believe, to be able to use VDCI to do the testing again one more year. We didn't have great data yet last year because it was such a drought, but.
Did we get any data?
I believe we do, I don't know, I don't have it here, but I think she could probably provide what we did get. I know it wasn't a lot because it just, the season was what it was, and you can have ups and downs and that, but the whole idea is to kind of track that and see where we're at. I'd love to get some data for a few years so you could find out, is this worth it, is it not worth it, how, I mean, I think it's only gonna be on the rise in the future, but being a part of this Pioneer Valley mosquito district would have quite a few benefits that waterways, different things like that you could do if we wanted to go into areas and clean out certain culverts or different things, you would have to deal with a lot of environmental issues that you have to do now, but.
How much do we get a grant for?
Just let me through, are you saying this is a way of getting around the?
No.
Environmental laws?
That's what I heard, didn't you?
That's what I heard.
That's what Carolyn wants to do, get around the environmental laws?
Who was that, who was thinking? No, I don't think Carolyn would love to scoop that.
They got you on TV, so make sure you speak clearly.
I was very clear.
No, it is not.
The question, how much is the grant that we received for the, to set up the mosquito district?
Wendy would know that, I think, it's a Community Compact Grant, I think it was $35,000 we got from the state for regionalization part of that grant to work with hiring of you know, kind of getting everything aligned. I think Charlie Kinnicky is going to be working to try and get some of this stuff up and running. I think there's a meeting, let's see, on the 4th. It was canceled because of the snow thing, to find out what SRB, which I guess the state agency, the State Reclamation Board, and they're the one that grant mosquito districts. There hasn't been a district, I think, since the 70s. Berkshires have a district, Cape, Essex County, obviously, they have a huge issue out there. But there hasn't been one. And a lot of times, I think it's because the, you know, a lot of these other districts have the money taken right off their cherry sheet. They don't have any way to say, you know, if they go in, it is what it is, and it just comes right off. Here, we're hoping if we do get the opportunity to be a district, then we would just, hoping the state would just give us a voluntary contribution, and then we would figure out what the baseline is, what, you know, you get so many traps a year.
So it is a boundary then. We get so much per mosquito.
There is, yes. Mosquitoes, they have a little.
So after the state grant goes away, we spend the $35,000, it's going to be up to the district members to fund whatever we're going to do.
Correct.
So we have no idea what that is.
Not yet. I think they're getting.
I think we should still save that $11,000 then, just in case we need to.
Well, you're kind of missing the point, because then you miss that. You need some data. You got to have data, or else you're not going to know what you're looking for.
It's going to be dry again this year. You're not going to get them.
How do you know? You don't know. I think it's a good program. I know everyone likes to poke fun at the mosquitoes and, you know, do that kind of thing. It's easy to do that. But one child, you know, gets hurt.
What about ticks? I'm more concerned about ticks than mosquitoes.
Well, we could set a tick district.
Well, let's change this from mosquitoes to ticks.
We can do that. We can get a double district going. No, what I'm saying is that.
Ticks are a much bigger issue.
You have some, you know, you start paying for education on a child who gets hit, because they're playing on the ball field or by the school at dawn. If we know, if we have some data, maybe we'll find in 2 years, we just don't have those mosquitoes here. I assume we do have some, but if we carry, you know, as climate changes, if we get some mosquitoes that carry Zika, which is as far north, I mean, Carolyn knows this a lot more than me, but as far north as I think winds are lost.
That's the scary part.
If you get, you know, if one of these gets hit with this thing, we spend a fortune on education on one child. I mean, you're not going to hit them all. You can't block it all out. But I do think it's worthwhile to protect our
what
kids.
Other towns are contributing?
I think we're killing a mosquito with a sledgehammer.
No one has contributed yet. There are different districts, obviously, that do all over the state. But in this area, from, say, Worcester over to the Berkshires, a few towns in the Berkshires, there's been nothing. Nobody's really getting data. I think Northampton, West Springfield, East Long Meadow, there's Greenfield, Montague. There's a lot of interest up and down the river.
But no one has contributed. And we
no
contributed
one, no
last year, too.
No one spent any money yet.
We spend money last year?
We spent $11,000 with BDC. Yes, Northampton has. There's a lot of other towns that are contracting through BDCI. I don't know all the towns that are, but a lot of them take it on themselves. And they've been doing that because I think it has to do with the state. They had charged a lot to test the mosquitoes, and we really are trying to pressure the state to let us use UMass Lab, because we could get students from UMass, we could get, I think we could use their resources and their educational services to make the program affordable. If we're sending it all to the state, I think they just charge too much money to make it sustainable for a long term. You know, for some data for several years.
I just feel, once again, if it's that critical throughout the state, that the state should be funding it. Yeah. Individual towns shouldn't be left to face, one town here will do it, but all the towns surrounding you won't do it because they don't want to spend the money because budgets are tight now.
They are. That
and
makes sense.
I just see $11,000 with our town budget could go to other causes that
always can. It always can. Know, but so. I think health of our citizens is almost priority, and I think that if we let it up to the state, you know, they're just going to take the money from us anyway. So I think if we have control over the system and we can choose to back out if we want to, or decide if we want to get, I think the whole idea was to set this up, use the state money to set this up, see if we can get the program up and running, and then decide, is it worth it to continue? What are the total costs going to be? Is it something that's going to be sustainable for us? Because you're right, money's tight.
Once we start down this road, though, as we've learned, it's not going to stop.
Yeah.
You're not going to change it. So this is, as far as I see it...
Are we doing anything to eliminate the mosquitoes?
What's that?
Are we doing anything to eliminate mosquitoes?
Well, we do, if we find, I think if we do find areas...
I mean, anyway, I mean, because some...
No, I don't think there's a lot, I mean, there is some culvert stuff, or they do it, not an adult aside, but an insecticide.
That they throw into the catch basin.
Exactly, they'll do a little bit of that, but I mean, we've got a lot of areas in town that, we've got Bloody Brook here, it's just probably festering.
Tell the farmers to use tires to hold...
Exactly, just drill some holes in those things, it'd make a lot, they're just, they're right.
Yeah, that's a lot of holes to drill, some of the farms.
You're right, I wish there were better ways to hold that stuff down, or use different items that didn't hold that stuff. I don't think you'll ever get it all, but I think the whole idea with this is that we would be, it wouldn't be $11,000 a year, that would, she's hoping to have it. She was talking half that, to have your amount of, your base buy-in for testing and knowledge, but...
I'd rather spend $11,000 and teach kids what they can do so they don't get pneumonia.
It'd be wonderful, I'd love to spend a lot of other...
Instead of mosquitoes.
Well, we have a motion on the table that I made to reduce the Board of Health budget by $11,000. There's no second yet.
To bring it to 24,530?
To bring it to 24,530.
I second it.
Any further discussion?
I think there's one issue that we have to bring up with the selectmen to resolve it.
Well, they're going to bring it up.
But we should...
We can do that tomorrow night, because the selectmen will be here, we'll be here.
I thought we had a meeting at Frontier.
There's two meetings.
Well, Frontier's meeting about their budget, but you guys going?
I didn't know it was rescheduled for tomorrow. I was planning on being here for the CIPC and then select board, but...
No CIPC tomorrow.
There's not, that was...
29th.
It's a good thing you came to this meeting to find out what's going on.
I know, you're here at 5:30, whether we're...
Right, Jeff?
I have it for the 29th.
The 29th?
Yeah.
And these guys are on a ball, so I know that's correct.
Yes.
Absolutely.
It's 29th.
Thankfully, somebody is.
Yes.
So we have a motion.
Call the question.
We have a motion.
We have a motion, question, second.
That takes a vote, so if you don't do that, we'll just vote the thing. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Well, wait, Board of Health, let me make sure everybody understands, we're voting 24,530.
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstention? I'll abstain. 6-0-1? Is that? Okay. And we'll talk about this tomorrow night.
Okay.
I'm sure we will. I'm sure we'll talk about the first thing that...
Sure it'll come up.
Yeah.
Do you need to abuse me anymore, or you...
No, you're doing a fine job.
Stick around, we're having fun.
You did a very good job.
Okay, senior center expense.
I have a couple of questions.
Sure.
The director's salary is split in two fiscal years.
That's right.
It's got FY17 at 2003 and FY18 at 2196.
No, I mean, those are the salaries in those 2003 and 2196.
That's the only time I was saying. Very few have it that way. Is there a reason why?
Well, just letting people know what it was. 2003 was what is currently this year.
So the average of that is what her salary?
No, 2196 is next year. I believe.
I don't think so. It's 1,560. 6 hours and 17 at $20.30.
So that should have been $30,000, shouldn't it?
Yeah, it's something not right.
Yeah. So...
How many hours?
1566 at 2003, but that says FY '17.
Which is the current?
Which is the current year.
Okay, and that comes out to 31,367.
Then FY '18 budget's 2196.
At 1566?
No.
Hours?
Yeah.
Times?
2196.
21.96 equals 34,389.
That's correct. That number is correct. 34,000.
Well, we put that in.
Right. Yeah, that's with that tentative compensation schedule.
Exactly. And the next ones also.
So, are any of these employees on grants?
Yes.
The outreach.
You know, I think, my guess is that.
They bring extra money in for doing extra jobs.
Doesn't pay for the salary.
No.
It used to, but now because there's no more grant for their salary.
They get grants, but usually it's for extra services.
No, outreach coordinator is a grant.
The outreach coordinator is a grant, but they're in the budget for $7,920.
Does it show down below? I think it comes off. I don't know which one of these.
I have no idea.
Yeah, one of these grants, I think, is that. And I wanted to say it was.
There may be a mistake. It seems to me that, in talking with Wendy, Wendy did an evaluation of the coordinator's job, director's job, and increased, it ended up increasing from grade 2 to grade 3.
Because of her responsibilities, yeah.
And so, there, my guess is that 2003 is inaccurate. But I'm not sure why.
That's what she's getting paid now.
I just know, I wonder if that's what she's actually, what was budgeted last year.
Right.
Was based on that 2003.
Possible. Yeah.
So, the outreach coordinator, my concern, I just, if they are paid by a grant, I'd just like to know there's an offset.
Is there an offset down here?
There's an offset on the bottom.
There is an offset down below.
Well, there's several offsets.
Which one is it? Yeah.
Down below. I don't know.
Well, Central pays 25, Whately pays 25, Deerfield pays.
Yeah, yeah.
No, there's an offset up above that.
Above, there's the grants.
Okay, then you've got grants.
Yeah.
It would've been nice just to know.
Which one of those it came from?
Well, it would've been nice to know what those grants are for.
It's an outreach coordinator.
No, I realize, there's three grants.
Right, but which one is it?
It's a formula grant, there's a Title III grant, and there's an SIG grant.
I'm gonna say it was around $10,000, but.
And that goes away.
It does.
It's only 1 year, so next, in '19, they need another grant to fund that position.
Or it would be gone.
Wendy's gonna be here tomorrow night, right?
Yes.
So.
We can find out.
We can, I think Wendy is, would be the one that needs to give us the explanation.
Right.
Any other question?
Yeah, I know it's not big dollars, but I'm just curious why we're paying for snow removal and landscaping.
Well.
Why can't the highway department send a guy?
The reason they do that is because it's a three-town venture. Like Frontier Regional is a three-town, four-town venture.
So, the highway department could bill them.
The police department.
Maybe that's what that is. Maybe that's what that is.
They have, I think they have Sokolowski do that.
Sokolowski.
Police department drives through the parking lot.
That's to pack it down. So, do we charge for that?
It should be.
How they gonna do that with a motorcycle?
We may find that it's cheaper.
They have to go back around.
Have Sokolowski do it.
Right. We may find, John, that it's cheaper having Sokolowski do it than the town.
It'd be nice to do a study. It'd be nice to know that.
Because of the rates that we're paying.
It'd be nice to know that.
Right.
We should know that.
Because you're not paying benefits or anything else.
If Sokolowski do everything.
And lay off a couple of people.
A lot of things have to be considered prior to.
This year, they didn't include insurance and employee benefits.
Mobile cemeteries?
Yeah.
No one's getting insurance.
For that salary?
I have no idea.
So, they're both zero. And you would think that they would be in there so they get prorated out.
I know one year they forgot to put it in, but.
Retirement's up $3,000.
One year they forgot to put it in, but I don't know whether they're under it or not.
I mean, the reason that it's in there now is so that we can split the cost, but.
Well, that would be the reason we wanted any, but it's not in.
Yeah.
One thing I just wanted to mention, which I didn't see in here, was oil, and if, because I don't know if we use oil at the other building, but we're going to use it next door. And so we're going to have to budget something for that. I don't know what the church normally uses to heat that for the year.
Wendy's going to put that piece together.
She's going to, okay.
It's a separate budget, it would help.
Yeah, at least initially.
This is with the current building, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
We got to separate those.
I have no idea why, well, they've got gas, okay.
Yeah.
You also have to look at the water sewer.
That one out.
Yeah.
I mean, that took a big jump, so.
Yeah.
And obviously, the sewer was issue, an issue.
It shouldn't be.
Had to be addressed.
It shouldn't be that.
It shouldn't.
No, it shouldn't be.
Seems too much, yeah.
Should be less than $1,000.
Right.
On the other hand, since we're only paying half.
Let them pay.
Good point.
Okay, can I have a motion on this, or we have more questions, right?
Make a motion, we authorize $25,776 towards the senior center expense.
I'll second it.
All those in, well, any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? 7-0, unanimous?
Yep. There's enough questions in this that need to be answered. Benefits, the big one.
What's that?
Benefits.
Benefits?
Yeah. Why aren't the benefits included in what grant?
I think the last person I had working there required health insurance, but I think she does not need it.
The new director doesn't need it?
That's what I understand, but I don't know.
Must get.
Huh?
Is it the only benefit?
She may not, well, depending on how many hours she, well, she's been 15-66, so it doesn't take that bad.
So she must be getting sick and personal on vacation.
Not that close, though, because we have a representative from the select board who takes care of that.
We do.
What?
Senior center?
What? What did you just say?
We used to have one.
And it says we have a representative from the select board that oversees the senior center.
Well, those are all based on days, which would be salary, included in the 2,088 hours anyway. Or whatever they are. It's prorated, but.
I don't know, Paul.
Well, your sick day is based on a work day that you didn't take and is being compensated.
Sick and personal vacations are already compensated.
That's what I would.
The only question is health insurance?
Right, that, and I know last year.
Doesn't take it.
I know that last year, that subject came up, and she has opted not to take it on the health insurance.
Last year?
I believe it came up last year. That subject came up last year.
So workman's comp and all that, we pay disability, all that's $55 in the last year? Under insurance, other?
Right.
And benefits, I don't know. It was $55 last year.
Well, that made.
No big deal, so we're moving on.
Okay, Tilton Library.
Tilton Library books, last year, $30,599. This year's financial through February, well, it doesn't matter, original budget, comes out to $18,706, the way I look at it. If I take the two 11 accounts, sub-accounts, add them up, I might be off a grand, no, $18,706. So how do you get $30,599 out of that?
Last year, this year. Are you saying that we've spent $18,000 so far?
No, that's what the original budget was for this year.
It was?
There was nobody.
Huh?
According to this.
No.
$30,000.
No, I'm looking at the expenditure report through February. It doesn't matter, it's the original budget.
Yeah.
On here. It's $18,706.
Do you see any other?
No, everything else tied out. Supplies doesn't make sense, but it's relatively small amounts. Everything else agrees.
Yeah.
And then she's looking for additional hours this year. I know she was given additional hours last year.
No, we're talking.
No, we're talking about last year.
Supplies, books, purchase of books.
2017 books is on here.
$30,000.
$30,599. And the expenditure report for the town is $18,706.
Do you want to change it?
The $30,000 was what was authorized. That doesn't mean that's what they spent.
No.
No. No, that's what I'm talking about, the original budget.
Wasn't changed at town meeting, I think, right?
I don't know.
Where's the $18,000?
Right there, these accounts here.
And no other account for books?
Nope.
DVDs, that kind of stuff. I know there's nothing here for.
Audio, video, books, all together.
Yeah.
So they got everything, audio, video, everything.
Nine, 12. 12, 15, 17, 18.
18,706.
Okay.
So now they got $30,000 in here on our sheet, and we're looking at it saying, oh, they don't want much of an increase.
What's the bottom line?
For the library, the whole thing?
Yeah.
193, 184.
6%.
They don't have the credits, though, on here, I don't think.
$8,900 increase.
And that's got capital expenditures, so.
Yeah, because this one shows $161 total.
Yeah.
Budgeted.
Right, but you got to add the credits, because those aren't.
Those aren't the same.
Those aren't in, on here, but you've got to subtract the capital expenditures.
In their narrative, they have that $31,291. 90% of the total municipal appropriation must be spent on books and materials in order to be certified for state aid.
Right.
This amount is increased proportionally to the average increase in the area. It's 2.26% for this fiscal year. $8,300 of this amount will come from the Tilton Fund, Inc., and Friends of the Library, Inc. So they're listing it there, but I think down below.
Yeah, you see the credits.
On that page.
Oh, okay, I'm with you. Yeah, right.
I think they put it there.
If we take 30.
Get state aid.
99 minus 14,925.
So 14,925, and this year's 99,628.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Okay.
Yeah, I think that's where, that way they can put it all there and then get state aid.
Right, okay.
So they shift it.
But I still can't.
So they take it away from below.
So.
We still don't, still doesn't tie out.
It doesn't?
193, but they got capital items in here, too. Let me subtract those out.
So why can't that be?
It comes closer, though. $15,000 off that, it only takes, leaves you with about $16,000 that they.
They have to budget.
It's within like $600.
Yeah.
If I take the capital items out.
Okay.
All right, what do you want to do?
It ties out. I can tie it out.
I have a question on the Tilton Fund.
Which is it?
The Tilton Funding. Last year was $15,000. This year is just under $10,000. Is that, is there a reason why it would decrease?
Yeah, I had that same question.
I have no idea.
And all the others have increased. It'd be about the same amount of money. But Tilton Fund, Inc. decreased.
They had to put more in last year than they have to this year, maybe?
I don't know.
They may not have the money in their Tilton Fund.
Exactly. I guess that might be it.
South Deerfield Water. South Deerfield Water Supply District.
So there's nothing in here for sewer?
No, because they're not on sewer. Aren't they on a, yeah, they got a septic fee.
This is almost a $3,000 raise.
They don't have, they're not on town water. For sewer?
I don't see a septic fee.
Yeah, right underneath the heating. There's South Deerfield Water District. And then there's.
Static IP.
I don't think that's septic.
Yeah, this has on.
No, they don't have anything. They don't have anything.
I don't see a sewer.
There's no sewer on here.
I don't have a problem with it.
So.
I make a motion, we accept it.
I don't see a sewer fee on here.
Yes, it is.
Where?
Um, $400.
$400.
Wastewater, $50 to $400.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
$400 doesn't even cover the minimum charge.
Well, yeah, that's the basic charge.
They only asked for 63. Somebody, we put the rest of it in there.
The $200 every 6 months times two for a year's thing is $400 without even using a sewer. So $400 isn't enough.
So $450.
What?
Well, 50 times six is $300.
$450.
So the minimum fee is, you're right, it'd be $450.
So basically.
You're at the minimum.
The salary increases are by the percentage.
Yeah, I don't think we ought to hold that up with $400.
Take a look at.
$50, okay.
I made a motion, we approve it.
So you're making a motion for $169,972.
No, $160, why are we doing that?
Turn the next page.
You got to turn the page over.
Oh.
You got the old one.
Mine does, we have a new one? I didn't get it.
No, on the back.
On the back of it.
On the back of the first one.
You got it on the back, haven't you?
Right there.
Oh, look at that. Okay, I make a motion, we approve $169,972.
Yep.
It's a big increase, though.
Yeah.
Part of that salary.
But it's a lot of it's.
Most of it.
A lot of it's a Tilton fund, too.
Actually, when you take a look at it, yeah, it's at least that.
Hey, motion, do we have a second?
A second.
Got a motion, we got a second. If there are no further questions, can we take a vote? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
I'm abstaining. One abstention.
One abstention, so 6-0-1?
Yep.
I already wrote 7-0-0.
That's your unlucky number now.
So it's going down to 6-0-1 now. So the next one looks like summer swim salaries.
Yeah, do we hire somebody?
I don't know.
Subcontract?
What's the 1,800?
18.
Adjustment to get the voted amount.
What are we talking about now?
Last year.
Last year.
On what's the budget?
Adjustment to get the voted amount.
Which budget are you looking at?
Summer swim program salaries.
When you add it up, it did not add up to $8,000.
Oh, so the town must have voted for $8,000.
Someplace along the way, they deducted $1,800, so that it would come up to $8,000, okay?
Right, and they don't know which line item to change, so, okay.
Well, that's the issue.
Got it.
That's the issue I have, is we're paying somebody $18 an hour, how do they fit on our schedule for part-time employees?
And they did it the year before also, they.
And $14 is over that rate, and the 8 is under, at $10 an hour.
And this is also the budget where we've got $11,000 in the.
Revolving?
In the revolving fund, right?
Right.
And I asked Brenda today, and she just shook her head and said, I don't know. So this is the selectmen's problem.
Maybe they need the $11,000 for mosquitoes down there.
There you go.
There you go.
They're going to have a ton of mosquitoes, you guys cutting it.
Well, now we know you're going to get the $11,000.
That's probably the worst place for mosquitoes.
I know.
All right, I wouldn't, if I had a child who knew all these things, they wouldn't go down near dusk.
Well, let me ask you.
Mosquitoes.
That's one of those funds that there's people on the swim program, even though it's there.
What?
Do the people on the swim program people even know that fund exists? I mean, it's all new people on that board, on that commission.
I don't think they do.
That's.
Right.
Right, and I, because I think that that particular fund has been unused for several years. And so.
We put something like $1,500 into it last year, didn't take any out.
Exactly, and I think the year before it was the same thing, and so.
And did you get any more information out of Brenda than I got?
On that particular thing?
Yeah.
Well, it is a 53D and not a 53.5, so it's a little different requirements for spending the money.
Yeah, but.
But.
No one seems to know what the.
Can't use it for salaries?
But, what's that?
Can't use it for salaries?
Yes, you can use it for salaries, but the way.
Looks like we might have done it last year, 1,800.
Well, there again, did anybody know it's even there? No, that was an adjustment to get a vote. There's several of these that we've actually gone over have that same thing. And so I'm assuming that, you know, there were some numbers that didn't work out in the committee. But the way it's written, they have the sole discretion of using it, but they have to get the sign off by the Board of Selectmen to spend it.
How much do they have?
I think it was, swim program, $11,638.15. That's as of February. The 7-1 balance, 7-1-16 balance was $10,078.15.
What's the number name?
That's what I'm saying. There's revenue put into it.
What was the name?
What's the number?
But no expenses taken out.
What's the fund number?
$630,5400.
Fund 220.
No, the fund number.
Oh.
224.
What's the fund for?
It says swim program revolving fund.
Okay. Several years ago, we let that build up. Because it was like any other recreational department, and they were given Sue authority to run, save their money, so that in the future they could cut back on their budget a little bit. So the bottom line is, I don't know if they know, like you say, that the fund is even there, and what it's to be used for.
Sneaking out early?
We're efficient.
You just left John behind, right?
So John parks by the other door.
Should we deal with this the same way we dealt with planning board?
I'm not sure I'd cut them to a buck.
No. I think we at least ought to take 1,800 off.
Level funded.
Well,
if we're going to do anything.
We don't have.
I personally have to vote against it because I voted. I made the motion for the other reserve fund.
Yeah, I agree. Use that money there. Why are we raising money through taxes when we got money?
Why my tax bill have to go up? Because we already have
money.
Yeah, if
they got it sitting there, right?
Is that total right?
It's like free cash in a way.
Is that right?
I don't know. I would say from the figures.
What's your question?
I'm not sure what. There was a fund and we allowed them to keep the money because they have to repair their own buildings and stuff like that.
Say if they got our expenditures.
Yeah, well, that's why they left money in there for them. And it's not just to support, support whatever they need. But if they need a new roof on a building, they don't come back and ask for an appropriation for that. They take it out of the funds that they have, and that's the purpose of that fund.
Yeah, but this is just.
Well, I don't understand this at all. I mean, is just Deerfield kids can take the swim program?
This is just Deerfield.
Well, can't other
Deerfield
kids go?
Runs the program, runs but they program. Allow other kids to come in from other towns.
They pay a fee.
They pay a fee. But
they pay a fee.
It goes into that reserve account.
Right.
Yeah. Do Deerfield kids pay a fee?
And we no. set up when we set up reserve accounts, they have to have a specific use. They can't be for any general maintenance. Unless we've said that. So why don't you know what the reserve account says?
What about adults? Do they pay a fee? Yes.
Adults pay a fee to get into the thing. We're talking about the swim program.
That's not
different thing, okay.
Different budget.
That's Drytown Beach.
Okay, I'm sorry, right, okay.
All right, what do you want to do with this?
My mistake.
I make a suggestion.
Sure.
It would be to pass the budget, and then when we try to bring these all together, consider that as a funding source for that particular program.
It's okay with me, just so long as you remember it. So we go through.
Anybody?
Don't worry, Bruce will remember.
Okay,
I'm writing it down right now.
I think we should try.
Both Bruce's
well,
will
I mean,
remember.
That's a suggestion. I mean, it's.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
It's a good idea.
So I think we should subtract $1,000.
We got Bruce backed up by Bruce, so we're all set.
Bruce squared.
Yeah.
They voted last year for $8,000. I think we should make it $8,000
this year. I agree.
I
make a motion that we approve. An $8,000 budget for a summer swim program salaries.
I'll second it.
Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? So if there's no further discussion, we're voting on the $8,000 number. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous?
Yes.
Okay. Tri-Town Beach. Tri-Town Beach. John, this isn't ours. This is Whately's, right?
What? Well, this is ours.
I mean, they're the ones that...
We pay 78% of it.
We pay 78%.
We pay 78.
Yeah.
I see it's changed. Whately's portion's 23 now, so they must have gone up in population. So we pay 77.
That's why it's based. I was wondering how that was based.
Well, it's supposed to be split between Sunderland, Whately, and Deerfield.
Is Sunderland still here?
Well, not anymore.
Sunderland never joined.
It should be Bytown Beach.
Yeah, but it's listed as Tri-Town by state law.
Is that right?
Yes.
Yes.
And one town backed out.
Backed out.
And I guess who?
Okay. Tri-Town Beach. Any questions?
Yes.
Go ahead.
What is a gatekeeper doing at 325 hours and a gatekeeper at 112 hours? So you've got 437 hours.
Keeping people out.
Well, yeah, but is it worthwhile? Because you've got $5,000 worth of gatekeeper expenses, and you're only, last year, had an income of $4,000. So it's kind of like, well, what's the purpose?
So we can spend money for them.
So, well, it just seems like it's kind of a negative number.
Either that, or you just open up the beach and don't have any gatekeepers there. The gatekeepers start off by selling passes to bring income in. I still got problems with the way they do that because there's total lack of accountability.
I agree. No, they didn't. We had this discussion, right, last year.
Yes.
We had brought them, right? Do you remember that? Yeah. And they came in and kind of were, newer people were on the board. We're going to get it under control, right?
We've tried to get receipts out of them.
Yep.
And the guy who was in charge says, well, I threw them away.
Yeah.
This is
you don't do that.
This is not Deerfield. This is a Whately.
But they don't, we pay the budget.
The problem we have is this.
We pay 77%.
Right, so if...
But they tell us what our share is.
So they've come up with all these hours, the lifeguard, they've done all these calculations.
Yes.
Yep.
To determine what's needed.
But this is only part of the budget, correct?
Pardon?
I have no idea. Don't ask.
These...
I never did understand.
Doesn't Tri-Town pay some of this, too? They have a separate account for Tri-Town.
Who does?
Tri-Town.
The Whately?
No.
No. Well, they got here, they have expenses to come from revenues. Maybe that's what that account's used for.
Well, maybe.
We're talking relatively small dollars for a $4 million budget.
Right. No, I agree. There's a net increase, $1,500 in maintenance, and that's pretty much the difference.
Right.
It does beg the question, what happened to the $4,001 that, we've got all of the salaries and...
I circled those two.
I think it's paid.
That's to pay for the expenses down below. See expenses to come from revenue?
I think the money that they get, they keep.
Okay, expenses to come from revenues, okay.
Right.
I'm assuming that's $4,000, the expenses then.
I wouldn't add it up. It's much more than $4,000. So don't add it up, otherwise they're going to increase the budget. Okay.
It's zero this year.
What's your pleasure?
I make a motion we accept the budget for $16,242.
Second.
Because we're talking small dollars between what might actually happen and what's being requested.
And we can't get information anyways. So, all those in, any more discussion?
$2,910 is the total.
What's that?
$2,910.
So it's off $90 between the receipts.
And then they adjusted to go to the now.
Right.
You got a motion?
Any second?
Okay, we have a motion, second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Okay. Recreation Department Director's salary. There's no change in hours. Change is the salary schedule.
I make a motion to move the rec department director's salary.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Me.
Opposed. So 6-0, 6-1-0.
Any specific reason? You want me to write it in there?
Huh?
Will you write something in there?
No, I oppose. I just, I think it's a, it's a 4% raise.
No. This is one of the smaller ones.
A lot of it.
Huh?
This is one of the smaller ones.
Yeah, I know, but it's still, I think all of them should be, I disagree with all of them.
Okay.
It's actually.
So is it 6-1-0, is it?
6-1-0.
Okay. We have unfunded.
Sick leave.
Sick time, vacation leave. That's number is, what is that? That's down in the.
9, 10, 50. Don't have a page for that.
It's in, it's down someplace.
It's 9, 10.
9, 10.
It's actually the article, isn't it?
Where's the proof? 9, 10, what?
It's an article.
There was on the.
I don't see a sheet for it.
I have a sheet for it.
There is no sheet for it.
I have a sheet for it.
Oh, I have a sheet. This came in.
I have a sheet, but I have no account.
No.
The new pile.
No account number on it. This says sick leave.
It was with our package last week.
Yeah. 9, 10, 5800. Under the 800, 900 series intergovernmental and benefits.
9, 10, 5800?
9, 10, 5800.
I know it's Daniel one.
10.
9, 10.
5800.
5800. Unfunded sick leave and vacation. This is yours. Bless yours. Stop quickly.
Oh, yeah. There it is.
Okay. Mary, what do we use this for?
This is for when somebody leaves at the end of the year. They retire and they have to get paid their sick time. That's not in their budget at that point. Because if you leave, you get so many days sick time for the number of years you work. And you also get whatever vacation time you have left if you leave. So it's not in the budget to start with.
Of course, you give up a 6.5% raise when you leave.
Everybody left.
The vacation time's in the budget.
The 6.5%, they never leave.
Right, but then.
Right.
And John is correct. Since we're giving 6.5% raises, nobody's going to leave.
Yeah.
We'll never get rid of these people.
Everybody's right in the middle of the chart, too.
Okay.
One year, we lost 4 management positions at the same time.
Cool. And it seemed to me that that was back in the days when people were able to build up an enormous amount.
Right, and I don't know many public agencies that allow you to take sick time with you.
Well, our bylaw says.
I understand that.
You can take one day.
For every year of service.
Providing you have sick time left.
Yeah, so you get 20 days. Work 20 days.
They spent $9,600 through February.
Yeah.
No, it gets spent.
I understand. It gets spent.
Okay, any questions on this? Maybe, if not, can I have a motion to approve it or not?
So moved.
So moved. It's moved, seconded. I'll second it. It's moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous?
Come out of retirement, go to work with town of Deerfield.
All right, let's see. Wastewater treatment plant. salaries and expenses.
I think, again, we have the superintendent in the wrong number. Then I have a question about the operator. Is the operator a salaried employee?
No, he's not.
He's an hourly rate employee?
They work weekends.
Work weekends.
And he's the only one that can work overtime, because he's the one who's...
The other two.
No, not by this book.
Benefits are up from 35% of wages up to 38% of wages.
So, would I, Mary?
Why?
Do you know whether the chief operator is the one that does all the overtime?
I think he has to, he's the only one that's licensed.
He's the only one that's licensed, no. They all have some licenses.
Some, but I don't think they can be by themselves.
Yeah, they can, because Marilyn works up their plant by himself.
Then I don't understand the line item, because he's got all the overtime. In total of his salary becomes $77,000.
If in fact...
If in fact he takes all the overtime.
I don't think he takes all the overtime, I think they split it, but it's all calculated to hire.
I know they all work overtime.
I know they do.
It's on a rotating basis, isn't it?
Right.
Okay, so then that's an overestimated budget. So somebody, if they work a rotation basis, somebody could figure out what the actual overtime costs are. It's only $2,000 or $3,000, probably $4,000, so it's not a big deal, but... You know, it's just the point. I would need a $2,700 raise, it's not too bad anyway.
With the wastewater treatment plant, salaries and expenses, what it's used for is to set, should be used for is to set the sewer rate essentially.
Yep.
All of that money comes into the reserve fund and paid out of the reserve fund.
Understood.
So if these...
Are too high or too low, it doesn't make any difference.
Too high or too low is gonna have a minimal impact.
Because your next one is $500,000.
Yeah.
Well, I have a problem with one of the operators with a decrease in salary of $63. When some people are getting $3,600 increases, and this one person is getting a $63 decrease.
Is that a new person?
He was hired in 2014. No, he doesn't. That's the chief operator. They've listed when.
He's not the only one that we've seen that has a decrease, but.
No.
I agree with you, absolutely.
That's the only one I've seen.
No, there are a couple others I saw.
You did?
I think.
Okay.
I was told that was only one when this presentation was.
Unless maybe it was ours, could be ours.
Could be ours.
I've got a note here, wastewater treatment plant salaries.
Why the benefits?
I don't think it's right.
Things to talk.
Why do the benefits go three, why do they increase 3% of wages over last year? Last year they had 35% of wages, now this year they're 38% of wages.
Because somebody's taking insurance.
It could be.
Insurance went up.
I was gonna say insurance went up in a general 8 to 10%.
Insurance went up 10%?
10%.
No.
County retirement went up 3%?
Yeah.
14 to 18, 4%?
Okay. Just for the record, there's a minor difference, and it's minor between the highway payroll regular and the highway overtime payroll, between that and what's on the highway department salaries, but it is peanuts.
Yeah.
But I just want everybody to know that we saw it.
The 12...
It's really small dollars.
On the wastewater treatment salaries?
Yeah.
The $12,000 one?
No, 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 the $4,450 and the $2,086.
Yeah, because they fill in sometimes over there.
But it's small.
So we're talking about if we go to the G2, step 8 for that person, looks to me... That there's a less than a dollar increase, there's $0.83 increase?
Yeah, it should be changed.
$0.87.
If you move that...
Up to the next step.
Step 8, step 7.
Yeah.
If, well...
I mean, steps don't mean anything, all it means you get a raise every year.
But he's going backwards in his raise.
He's going backwards, he may be going up two steps, but that's...
Well, I've got a note here to check the wastewater treatment plant salaries entirely, to see why...
It can't be based on merit.
No, it's not, it's steps.
I understand, so I mean, it's either we pay him the money that he's due, or we don't give him a raise.
No one moved back, no one lost money.
This one did.
I'm saying, that's the problem, because no one...
They're supposed to.
They weren't supposed to. I know, you get, there's a $63...
Decrease.
Decrease there.
There's a $0.87 potential increase to the next step.
I do a lousy job and I still get a raise. Must be nice.
I worked 20 years for a public sector and got three raises and they're all merit-based.
It's like baseball.
Should negotiate better.
Players get paid for, you know, doing their job 30% of the time, and they get paid well.
Nope, I don't buy it, not for this.
Okay.
That's what makes this difficult, is with the new salary schedule, it's almost like an automatic as far as approving these...
I know.
Budgets with, based on the salaries.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're plugging them into the new salary schedule, it really doesn't, and they're being placed supposedly where they should be, we don't really have any say, from what I can see, if we're gonna follow the new salary schedule.
There's no incentive, no incentive to do a good job.
No.
Well, I don't know if that's, I don't think that's fair.
Why? There's no monetary incentive.
There may not be.
I'm not arguing that, I'm just saying that on budget for us to do our job as far as voting the budget, we're very limited. I mean, you know, you can't...
Majority of the budget's a salary.
Right, if it's all salary, you can't really, I mean...
First of all, what we're doing is recommending to the town.
Right.
Right, yeah, well, that's what I'm saying.
It's all we're doing.
Right. I've said that before, I know we're...
So we're recommending that they get these big increases.
Right.
Which I disagree with, personally. I've said that enough.
Me too. I'm tired.
I wasn't sure, what did you say, John?
But I do believe you should go to a 20 step and do a 2.5%.
A 20 step?
20 steps, yeah.
Couldn't be as bad as the teachers.
Don't make a difference.
They just, they started with 10 steps and they just keep adding a step every couple of years.
I don't know how, but I think we're gonna do something.
Okay, so the budget, according to this, salary budget is up $12,000, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. Nonetheless, that's what they're saying. So...
$6,000 of it is benefits.
At least. Can I have a motion? One way or the other. Somebody wants to change it, I don't know what you change it to, though. You can vote it down, I guess.
Are we gonna make an increase in this?
What's that?
For this one employee?
I'm not at this point in time.
We're gonna make, have Brenda look at them.
They're gonna be looked at.
Yeah.
And presumably, we should be able to talk about these tomorrow night.
You want to put it on hold?
No, I was going to say.
I just assume vote something.
Let's vote exactly what they got, 252, 163. I'll make that motion.
This is an alternate 20-year for the five-year. This is how many employees we have and where they are.
We have a motion for 252, 164. Is there a second? I'll second it. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Who's voting hands? We've got three voting, four opposed, abstentions. So 4-2-1.
I'd like to find out about that one salary.
Okay, no, it's not a problem. I agree. It's, something's not right there. We've got the wastewater treatment plant.
Yeah, right.
We need to check them all. Wastewater treatment plant expenses. If you notice, wastewater treatment plant has gone from 290,000 to 416 to 432,000 last year to 502,000 next year.
I know why.
Okay, yeah, I don't, so.
Okay, equipment replacement. This year, they propose a $3,000 increase in equipment replacement. Seemed like that would be a capital item. It went from 28,000 last year, which was the first year that they had equipment replacement, to 31,000 this year. They also have pumping station maintenance, which is $90,000. That went from $77,000 last year. I believe we only have one pump station in town, but I might be wrong.
That's all we have.
And my question is, wouldn't it be cheaper to tear that one out, put a new one in, have a debt of $90,000 per year, instead of paying $90,000 every year in a budget?
For maintenance?
For maintenance, which is ridiculous.
Who's on the?
Me.
No, you guys just studying?
Yeah, we're trying to.
Trying to make common sense out of a real messy situation.
Yeah.
Literally.
That's a polite way to put it.
That was not what you wanted to say, was it?
No.
No, but I was close.
So that's an issue that we need to bring to talk about, but it's a maintenance item in this year's budget. Engineering consultant, $32,000. Went from 16 last year, I don't know if it's all spent, to the 32,000 this year. I just don't know if we have a cost estimate now for 32. The INI mitigation, we're putting in for 50,000. We had 25,000 last year. I don't know how we don't have any answers even at the sewer study committee. We've requested these answers. And there's also an increase in permitting of $3,500 from 55 to 8,000.
When does the sewer study committee next meet?
Thursday night.
Thursday night of this week.
Do you want to bring the budget up at that meeting?
We have nothing to do with it.
We have nothing to do with it. It's not us. It's just, what are we going to do? What plants are we going to?
It's the selectmen.
Go and fix.
We shouldn't even make recommendations. Because we don't even have, we can't get answers.
We're supposed to study this until December.
And make a report.
And give recommendations to the selectmen.
Yeah.
The only one that makes decisions for the sewage treatment plant are the three selectmen who act as the sewer commissioners.
Yep.
Period. We recommended to them that they increase all the fees to minimum of $200 per household. They did that. And I thought with that, that we were going to get $200 per house.
We did not recommend that.
I thought we did.
We made, the only recommendation at our first or second meeting, we recommended they continue with the same process that they currently have as a billing system.
But since then, we made a recommendation to the selectmen to go up to $200.
Selectmen made that recommendation. We didn't make a recommendation.
I
I think we showed them facts and figures.
Based on that report, that we were going to need to start spending more money on this thing?
Kip made the recommendation.
Yeah, but wasn't it based on that?
We showed facts and figures of where we were headed.
Yeah, but we didn't, and we couldn't even get that grant.
Wait a minute. Are you talking about the report that done by David Pritchett, who fails to finish it?
No.
Yeah, that's the...
No, it was the one, wasn't we have a guy, was here the first time?
Yeah, David Pritchett.
Right, that was David Pritchett.
So he had...
There's a preliminary study.
One of the issues that we had heard was that we're not charging enough. We can't even get a grant because we don't have charged enough.
That is correct.
If we're ever going to get any money to start doing this, we should raise this a bit at a time, you know, because we've got this huge expense coming. So that was, I think, the recommendation we were hearing from everybody around the table working on this, that we need to start charging more for it, or else we're never going to get any money to fix it.
We had so many questions, at least I did, had so many questions with the preliminary draft study, and we can't get a response on when they're supposed to make their public presentation and their final report.
Right.
And we've asked questions for additional information, which they offered at that meeting, that they would meet, work with us. They won't even talk to us.
That's not the firm where the guy left?
No.
No.
That's a different one.
So, I mean, anything that's based off that draft concept plan, it's got a $32 million expenditure built in.
Right. No, we certainly weren't covering $32 million, but I think what we were looking to do is to start a baby step here. I know it was a bigger than a baby step for a lot of people who are on sewage. I don't want to minimize that, but I think we had to start charging some and start going in the right direction. And I think we were going to just do this for 1 year, and we were hoping to get information from the sewer study committee to go, where are we going from here? What do we want to do? What do we want to spend money on here?
Have they already sent out bills for the 200?
What's that?
Have they already sent out?
Yes.
They did.
A minimum fee of $200?
Yes.
Yeah, I know. That's what the selectmen chose. Went from 50 to 200.
Well, they're the only ones that can make that decision.
That's right. We didn't even make that recommendation. And nor did the, I don't think, David Pritchett.
No, Pritchett didn't do it. I thought we did it in the meeting.
No.
There were spreadsheets made and presented, okay?
By Pritchett.
Well, it was one, you had one, I had one. We worked out different ones.
We had worked out the numbers of what it might cost, what the rate should be, not a minimum fee.
Right, okay. With alternatives.
With alternatives.
But it was not a formal recommendation of the committee. And, but, you know, it was working out to an education thing.
That's all it was. It was part of our process.
Well, we're moving forward. So you guys are working on that. We're moving down the road, right?
I don't know. I think we're at a standstill, to be
honest.
Well,
I agree with you. But I think we're getting off the Finance Committee charge right now.
I agree.
Yes, we are.
And I think we need to get back to that. Because that's...
So we do have all these increases. We don't know how they came about. We don't have the person represent.
I have a question. Administrative indirect expense?
That's what the town charges the sewer department.
Where's the credit on the town, on the town budget sheets?
That goes in the free cash.
Should be there. Should be there somewhere.
It should be there some.
Just like you've got one for SCIMS. There should be one.
There's no credit back.
I didn't see a credit.
No.
Maybe here and I missed it.
With my understanding that all that goes to free cash because they don't fool with it. It's a year behind. And they're paying us a year behind what we did.
So what do they do? Does the sewer people send a check of $22,000 to the town?
Town, and town puts it...
All they do is the same person's doing all the paying of the bills. All she does is put in a paper saying $22,000 is owed to the town of Deerfield. They take it right out of sewer reserves and put it over to the town of Deerfield. And she has a place where she has to account for it. Where she does that, I don't know.
I'm just looking for the credit on here.
It's like the $57,000, $58,000 we charge SCIMS. And that doesn't show up anywhere except for on paper.
Well, we voted that at town meeting to make sure that we got the money for 1 year.
I'm not looking for the actual cash. I'm looking for the reduction in the
budget. I know, I understand. We don't get, they don't do it that way.
It goes in revenue.
It goes in revenue. So we have a budget here, which
Which we really don't have any control over, right?
You and I don't. We pay a nickel on it. So I think I'm going to abstain.
Well...
The problem is, as a finance committee, it's our obligation to render an opinion on it, whether we like it or not.
I don't like, I think the, my opinion is it's not a good budget.
You can vote no. I don't have a problem with that. So can I have a motion for either the 5,000 or some other number? 500,000 or some other? But I'd like to have a motion.
I reluctantly make the motion that we authorize for wastewater treatment expense, $502,125, period.
I'll second it. I'm not even going to ask anyone else. Okay. Let's take a vote. All those in favor, raise your hand. All those opposed, raise your hand.
Could I abstain for lack of information?
Okay, two in favor, four opposed, one, so it's not voted.
I voted in the negative. It's not recommended.
It's not recommended.
Well, we really don't have any details on why it went up so high.
The recommendation then is to close the sewer treatment.
Yeah, sounds like a plan.
Okay.
The problem is that everybody in town gets one vote on this budget, whether they like it or not.
Yep.
And the problem is that there's a perception out there that everybody that's on the sewer gets a free ride. Just for the hell of it, today, when I was doing my taxes, I finished my taxes, and I said, I'm curious to see how much I spent on sewers. And the way I run my business is every year I have a separate accounting for Hyannis, a separate accounting for Elm Street because it's a rental property, and a separate accounting for utilities because that's part of the utility expense for me running a business out of my home. So it's easy for me to look up the numbers to see exactly what I had for numbers. I was kind of shocked and surprised that I went back 11 years, had all the numbers for 11 years, and out of 11 years, I think I spent for sewer for the town of Deerfield, $5,700 and something dollars for Elm Street, and another, I think the average between Elm Street and Sugarloaf Street, the two properties in South Deerfield, I paid over $800 a year for those two sewers. $800. Now, before we even went up. Before we even went up. And the perception is that we're getting a free ride. I can assure you, $400 a year is not a free ride because I don't think everybody who has a septic system is paying $400 a year to balance their budget.
Well, I disagree with you, John. If we're going to make this political, okay, if we're going to make this political, a lot of them might say here too. John, I disagree. I don't think that the, I don't think that the sewer user is getting a free ride, and I don't think anybody, or I don't think a lot of people in town think that. I think that's a misconception. And I will say that septic users, if you want to average out the cost per year, that the septic users right in the ballpark as a sewer user as far as cost, between the maintenance and the replacement over a lifetime of a septic system. So, and I don't want to distract from our budget here, our finance meeting, so let's move on.
I think I hear a collective toilet flush.
Right, exactly.
Everybody just went...
Oh, yeah.
Either that or they threw something at their TV, and they'll be buying a lot of TVs tomorrow.
So what budgets haven't we reviewed?
Skims.
Skims.
We don't have it, do we?
No, we don't. It's Brenda has it. She asked if I want it, and I said, not tonight. Not tonight. We'll worry about that.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
The only question I got for Skims is why are they voting the same money they did before for last year?
How do we know?
I don't know.
That's what it says in here.
You've got the number.
Yeah.
It's in there, I think. That's the...
As a matter of fact, it's not the same number. They lowered the budget by $5. for the town of Deerfield.
We voted the last FCAT meeting to cut the assessments by 15%.
That's what I thought, too.
That's not $5, it's 15%, a lot more than that.
I wouldn't trust those numbers.
It's like, typically, some people with a SCAMS budget have trouble adding.
Well, they do.
They're wrong.
Okay.
We'll discuss that tomorrow, yeah.
Is a motion to...
What do you want, a motion to adjourn?
Adjourn.
So moved.
I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.